she was surprised that she got it. But she said she was going to stick it in her office, but yeah, I just hope nobody steals it. There's an alarm on there. Well, they cost a lot of money.
They do pass a nice light to you. Is that wood?
She's setting up. Does anybody have any announcements? We're going to deal with that. On the agenda, it mentions that on November the 11th, Bodega Park's having something. So do you know more details about that, Betty?
It should be.
Susan?
It's December. December the 11th.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, the time. You know, I don't have the time.
Yeah,
so.
The first anniversary of the park. The actual anniversary would have been the day before, December 10th, but that's okay. It's for logistics reasons or whatever. So it's going to be a birthday party for the park, different events. The flyer is almost ready to go out, but it's going to be from 11 to 1, it might even be 1:30, but let's say 11 to 1. And various activities, lunch will be provided by a mobile kitchen group, and music, and the community garden. We're going to have a activation of the gardens. Anyway, a lot of things going on for that during those couple hours.
Oh, we'll wait for the flyer to find out.
And there'll be a flyer that we'll be getting around, yeah.
Okay, and then above it is the 7th anniversary annual holiday party of the Alliance for Better District 6, which will be at the Sweet Bar on December the 8th at 6 o'clock at 561 Geary. There'll be an awards ceremony, food, door prizes, and for those who picked up the blue sheet, it mentions who the awardees are on it on the back, various businesses in the neighborhood, 10 businesses were selected. Also, the Alliance for Better District 6 will have their annual celebration and awards ceremony at the round meeting on Monday the 25th at 6 o'clock at 201 Turk Street. There'll be a celebration, election of officers, door prizes, awards ceremony, food, and fun. There will be no December 16th TFC meeting. Yes, we need to have a break every so often. I think most people, it's a holiday month, so people probably not want to come to a meeting. Please let me know if you have any future agenda items for the next meeting. Will be January the 20th, 2016. Is there any other community meeting stuff that you know anybody knows about that wants to mention while we're doing this section? No?
Sure, Hastings always has events going on.
Nothing comes to mind.
No graduates in January?
No, we do our big show in May, Bay Breakers time. So, Betty, how's the park held up? It looks great.
Yeah, it's going great. Not only the park, but all the programming.
Yeah, it's so nice, especially at night, seeing kids running around there and playing.
We've got senior programming and exercise equipment, you know, supposed to be for adults or young, but the kids are on it too. But anyway, yeah.
Well done. Congratulations.
No, turn it.
You guys, I'm going to have to excuse myself, so I wish I could stay, but I can't.
They're great. It's like being 40 pounds lighter, and if you have to stand around a lot, it's great. I've been wearing these for 2 years.
You like it?
Yeah, this is about my fourth pair.
Do they give you support?
Oh, yeah. And it's good for the knees and everything. Yes.
Okay, we're having a presentation now.
Oh, there's stores in San Jose. You look them up.
Just all right. I know.
So introduce yourself.
Good morning. My name is Jesslyn, and I'm with the 5M Project. I worked in the nonprofit sector for over 14 years in the South of Market, and today I'm here with Forest City to present with you the 5M Project. And thank you for having me.
Okay.
So the 5M project is located right near 5th and Mission between Howard and Mission Street. And really it's at a C3 site where it is located in a transit-rich area. Powell Street is the most transit-rich station in all of Northern California. And so when speaking with, you know, the planning department, it was really an ideal place to put density on the site. The existing site today has actually no housing. It's 50% of it is parking lots. And right now, it currently does not have any open space. So the timeline of the project, really, it started out in 2008. Really, you know, there was this place where it really is a unique place that has 4 acres in downtown, which is really unique. And so, you know, Forest City went out and did focus groups with, you know, nonprofit leaders, small business owners in 2009, and residents to really gain a sense of what people, you know, said kind of around what the needs are in the community. What came through was really, you know, dedicating open space, you know, during that time. And then there was a comprehensive design charrette from 2009 to 2011, and you know, the draft EIR came out in you know, November of 2014 last year. Currently, then we went to the planning department, planning commission. I'm sorry, and then we went to the planning commission. We actually had 3 meetings at the planning commission, and then went to land use last week and was approved at the Board of Supervisors as of last evening. So really through comprehensive kind of going out to the community and then also, you know, speaking with the city, there were 6 goals of the project. So really what we've heard from the community is there needs to be a more greater level of affordable housing. 2, make sure the benefits are localized within the area. And then 3, open space. So what we heard from the city was, you know, create a mixed-use development of office and residential, forecasting the needs of the city, and really creating density near transit. And 3, along the skyline, make sure when you do build your designs, it's not just square boxes, but, you know, really having varied height within the design. And so previously, you know, our very first initial project, you know, had 4 new buildings. And now, you know, the approved project for the Board of Supervisors is 3 new buildings that are going to be built. And the reasoning was really making sure that we balance height and open space. What we could have done was really just decrease the height on the buildings, say, you know, 100 feet on each of the buildings. But then as a person, you know, standing on the ground and looking up, you wouldn't feel the difference from 400 to 300. And so, you know, what we've heard is people wanted to see more open space. And so that's what we did. So we removed an office building in the middle of the project and created more open space and really balancing height and that open space. So the project that moves forward is this project right here. As I said, there's 3 new buildings and about over an acre of open space. So this is the office building on Howard Street. This is a residential for sale building on 5th Street, and this is a rental building located on Mission Street next to the Chronicle building. You know, also the Chronicle local building will have open space, so you can go to the rooftop of it, and then also this area right here will be another portion that will be provided. We've had over 175 community meetings and tours since 2009, and since the initial study, over 130. Now I'm going to take you through some renderings around kind of just the visualization of what the space could be. So this is Mary Port, and this is how it looks now. And, you know, the vision for it is really another kind of area, community area that people can go to. These are just some ideas that people have brought forth, such as community farmers markets that are affordable, seating, you know, for, you know, seniors as well as families. Like, there's a little tot lot right here. There's not a lot of parks for, you know, I think that age group. So that's just another addition for. But we're in that, we're actually in the phase where, like, we're gonna get into that. What do people wanna see? And so moving forward, we're gonna really go delve deeper into that. What will this public open space be? We are also gonna pedestrianize Mary Street. So coming in from Mission to Minna Street, this is going to be pedestrianized to be able to bring people to move into the center of the site.
When you do that, does it stay a public right away?
So it, do you mean cars, can cars enter?
Well, I mean, is it still
yes.
Technically a city street?
Yes, it is still a city street, but it's just only bicycles and pedestrians are able to go through, but the rest of the other streets are still fluid, yeah. And so this is coming from Mint Plaza, looking towards the building that will hold the residential rental.
That's a TNDC project?
The residential rental is actually going to be a Forest City. We'll be building and managing that, but it will have 87, and I'll talk about this shortly, moderate to middle income affordable housing. So this is a rendering of the rooftop. We've heard a lot about urban gardens, and how this could also be a place for community gardens on the rooftop, and then just places for people to relax and see the city from, you know, a different perspective. This is the viewpoint from Petrero Hill. So the project is right here, and this is Petrero. Okay. So really through a culmination of a lot of community meetings, talking with the city planning department, we really, you know, came out with just not only the physicality of how the building looks, but a lot of comprehensive community benefits that are localized. And I'll be going over that. Like, we've reached housing. We've also are dedicating, you know, resources and a building to arts and culture. And we understand that the area has a lot of youth and families, so a lot of the community benefits I'll share with you reaches a lot of nonprofits that serve families and directly go to Bessie Carmichael, the only elementary and middle school in South the Market. And also a lot of transportation fees also go back to the city and back to the community. We've also heard a lot about workforce development and how that's integral within the community to make sure that connection happens on the ground to local residents. And for seniors, we have a senior housing that's gonna be built as far as with the affordable housing program and really making sure pedestrian safety, widening streets, you know, putting crosswalks where they're needed is an addition. And also community facilities and nonprofit space. There is gonna be funding for nonprofits to apply, knowing that rents have increased in the city, that will stabilize if they need capital improvements, et cetera. And then we shared with you earlier, you saw the renderings, how there's over an acre of open space. We are gonna retain all of the historic buildings. So that's the Camelite, Dempster Building, and the Chronicle. And then, as I said earlier, there's a lot of you know, pedestrian safety improvements with this project. And I'll go over that shortly. So what we've heard was the major thing that we've heard from community members, thank you, was that affordable housing is really what the city needs and the community needs. And so we've reached a level, and we'll be the first private project that reaches 40% affordable. And so they'll, what does that mean? So there'll be 601 units of market rate and a total of 241 units of affordable. And this, you know, went up from our 33% recently. So if, does anyone know where the Eddie and Taylor site is?
Yeah.
A block down. We're going to be able to help, finance 71 units of the Eddie and Taylor family housing, and which is going to have formerly homeless families within that, program. And so it's from very low to, low income. And then also right between 5th and 6th on Mission, there'll be a dedication of land and funding for senior housing. That'll be 83 units. And then on site, there'll be 87 units within the rental building for moderate and middle income households. So this is our affordable housing package, and we feel really proud that this has been able to become realized because of the need for the affordable housing and the crisis we're in right now. I'm going to move into the community facilities, open space, and historic preservation. As I said, this is, there'll be capital improvements for 447 Ministry, art programming for open spaces, nonprofit arts facilities fund, improvements for the Mint, and then the retention of the Cameline building, as well as we're still going to, of course, give our downtown open space fee, which is always part of what the fee are, and also really doubling the amount of open space from our first previous project that we were going to have. So the revised project has twice the size of the open space. You saw this earlier, so this building is the Dempster building, and we will be dedicating this to the Community Art Stabilization Trust. And they're, a nonprofit that helps arts and nonprofits organizations find a stabilized, affordable rents in the city. So we definitely see the Dempster building as an anchor, just like Bodecker Park having a lot of programming with the Boys and Girls Club. We see this building really activating the space on the ground floor. And, because of their programming, spilling over to the open space, so that it's really an active, very utilized open space in the area. So, as I said earlier, within this area, there's a lot of youth and families and seniors. And so, we also make sure that there's a lot of support for youth development. So the wraparound services are about $3.5 million. And it goes into the SOMA Stabilization Fund. And we also, do our child care fee. And as of recently, what's included is we're going to make sure that there's a study to see if we can do on-site child care. So, like I said earlier, we do a lot of transit impact development fees. It's about $8.9 million, so it's the base fee. But also above and beyond, we provide $3.4 million to pedestrian safety within the project and also around the project. And then we also are also doing the transportation demand management plan. This is just how the existing streetscapes look if you're walking down 6th Street or Mission Street. We're going to go over kind of what the public road enhancements are. We're going to widen the streets on 5th. We're also going to take out the pork chop right by the parking garage on 5th and Mission. So a little triangular piece of cement. You cross over, it's pretty hazardous. And so we're going to remove that and extend the sidewalk. And then on Mission Street, we will put street trees from 5th and all the way down to 6th Street. Workforce development was also one of the things that came through our community meetings.